And you're here and you're at the front. Praise God. And it might seem so impossible, but the Lord knows what he is doing. And before we move on, we just want to remind you this morning why we're here and what your role is. Praise God. I'm going to ask for you to be seated this morning. Praise God. And we're going to charge and we're going to commission our men. But before, I just want to speak to you a little bit, just a little quick reminder of what we're charging you with, what you are assigned with, your duty this morning. Praise God. Because sometimes we forget. I go to work day after day, and sometimes I said, why am I here? And then when I get the check, I'm like, that's why I'm here. But as men of God, every man, not just fathers this morning, but every male in this house this morning, in case you're wondering if I'm talking to you, whether you're 5 or 500, I am speaking to you this morning because you've been called and you've been positioned and anointed by God for service to him. Praise God. And sometimes we forget and we need to be reminded of our role. So as women in the church of the living God this morning, and I thank Sister Laurencia for the vision that God gave her, God wants to remind you this morning. So I'm going to stand here and I'm going to do my best to remind you of your role, because sometimes we miss the mark. And God wants for you as men of God to be reminded of who you are, to remind you to step up and to step in the gap this morning. Ezekiel chapter 22 and verse 30 said, I searched for a man among you, and the Lord found each and every one of you that's here this morning. So in case you're wondering, it was the Lord that found you and called you and has commissioned you. And he's commissioned you to stand in the gap. Praise God. He was looking for a man among you, praise God, to stand in the gap before me, before the Lord, praise God, for the land. So God has called you to stand in the gap for your church, for your family, for the land, praise God, so that it would not be destroyed. And so if your family, if your church, if your land this morning, the Lord is saying, is being destroyed, it's because there's some holes in the gap. So we want to remind you, and the women, the children, we're all looking to you this morning. We're reminding you of your role. It is to step up and to stand in the gap. It is your role, it is your call, your duty to speak out against sin. We're looking to you as children of God, as women, as children, as young people this morning. And we've called you to the front to tell you that we're looking to you to speak out against sin, not to cower in fear. And if you look at our world today, you can see men, you know, that they're becoming the laughing stock, or they're involved in violence. But that's not the way the Lord intended it. The Lord intended for us to speak out against the tricks of the enemy. So men of God, the Lord has commissioned you to open your mouth. Be courageous, to be strong, to speak in truth, to speak love, to speak the word of the Lord. Praise God. Do not get weary in well-doing. I want to encourage you and to tell you that we have your back. As women in the church of God, we are praying for you. We have your back. It might seem like no one has your back, but POB women, POB young people, and POB children have your back, and we are praying for you. The Lord is with you, and he will keep you, and he will guide you. He's an awesome God. Praise God. So we're going to ask all the men this morning to stand up. If you're in the back, we're asking you to come to the side. We're asking you to stand this morning. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. We're going to ask the congregation to stand behind our men this morning. Praise the name of Jesus. He's a prayer answering God. He's a good God. And we're going to ask the men this morning just to lift your hand to the Lord. Your strength comes from the Lord. It doesn't come from you. It comes from the Lord. He is an ever-present help in trouble. In time of trouble, praise God. Hallelujah, Jesus. So we're charging you this morning with the task, praise God. We're charging you, and we're asking for those that are behind the men to stretch your hands towards them this morning. Stretch your hands. They need your word. They need your strength. They need your prayers. They don't need your criticism. They don't need for you just to analyze them when they're doing wrong. They need your prayers. They need your word of encouragement. They need your love. Men, this is where you belong. You are our leaders. And we just want you to know that we are praying for you. It doesn't matter whether you're 17 years old or 7 years old. Praise God. You are our leaders. We are looking to you in our homes, in our church. We are looking to you. Praise God. And if that's not the way it is going, it is out of the principle and out of the alignment of God. Praise God.
You will fail if you do it under your Upon each of these men right now, Father, we pray. Dear Lord God, let them reach out to the power of the Spirit of God that dwells with them and among them and in them. Dear Lord God, help them to fulfill the call, their destiny, their responsibility as the leaders of their home, as the leaders of their church, as the leaders of the community, as the leaders of the places of employment. Father, help them to stand in the gap, to step into that situation, Lord God. And dear Lord God, fearing God and recognizing they're eschewing evil, they're brushing evil aside, God, let their focus and attention be upon you from this day forward. Father, we hereby commission these men of God, these adult males that are in this sanctuary today at this altar. Father, we are asking that you loose them for work. The Bible lets us know, God, in the last days you will pour out your spirit upon all flesh, and all men shall know that they are my disciples when they have love one for another. And Father, we're asking these men to go forth in the power of your spirit.
Yes, Lord.
And in the power of your love. Father, we hereby commission them in the name that is above every name. And everyone in the house of God said, let it be done in Jesus' name. Clap your hands unto the Lord Jesus today.